All right, here's the fourth video in our series for Section 12C. And in this video, we're going to look at two examples and talk about Webster's method of apportionment and the Hill-Huntington method for apportionment. So for Webster's method, we start off kind of the same way we've started off for all of them. We're going to find our total population by summing the population of all our four states, and then finding our standard divisor by taking our total population divided by the number of representatives, which is 100. And then I'm going to find my standard quota by taking the population of each state and dividing it by my standard divisor, which I'm going to lock in with cell F4. And pull that down. Then looking at the minimum quotas, when I sum the minimum quotas, you see that I have not assigned enough seats. I've only assigned 98 when I need to do 100. So for the Webster's method, we're going to use a modified quota. Again, it's very similar to Jefferson's method. And just like Jefferson's method, we'll either give it to you or we'll say, try, you know, guess and check four or five different values and then stop. You know, show all your work, show that you tried, and if you don't get it, that's okay. So don't feel like you're going to have to go on endlessly to do this, especially since some of these quotas are a little odd. And for this one, we're going to use the modified divisor of 99.85. So when we divided by 100, it didn't work. Now we're going to divide all of our state's populations by 99.85. And this time, instead of rounding down like we did in Jefferson's method, we're going to round using the standard rounding rules, where if it's 0.5, we go up, and if it's anything less than 0.5, we go down. So 9.49 rounds down to 9, 7.5 rounds up to 8, 6.4 rounds down to 6, 76.65 rounds up to 77, and now if we sum our seats, we've counted for all 100. So Webster's method is very similar to Jefferson's. We have a new divisor to find our modified quotas, but this time we round using standard rounding rules. The Hill-Huntington method is our last method, and it's very similar, but it's a little bit different. There's just one little twist to it. So again, we start off by finding our total population. I think y'all have got this part down pat by now. Then we find our standard divisor by taking our total population divided by the number of representatives. Then standard quota is our state's population divided by our standard divisor. And then when we look at the minimums, just like in the example before, when we sum our minimum quotas, they do not sum up to 100. So for Hill-Huntington, we're also going to try new divisors. And this time we're going to use a divisor of 100.06. So I'm going to take my population and divide it by that new divisor. And what the Hill-Huntington method says is we're going to calculate a value called the geometric mean. And to find the geometric mean, we're going to find the square root of the integers on either side of the modified quotas. So again, we're going to find the square root, which in Excel is equal SQRT, of the product of the two integers on either side of the modified quotas. So for our first one, the modified quota is 9.4. The integers on either side of it are 9 and 10. So to find the geometric mean, we take the square root of 9 times 10. Those are the integers on either side of the modified quota. For the next one, we're going to take the square root. This time our modified quota is 7.4, so it's going to be 7 times 8. Then our next geometric mean is the square root of 6 times 7, so those are the numbers on either side of 6.4. And our last one will be the square root of 76 times 77, because they're the integers on either side of 76.49. So to find our rounded values, we're going to compare our modified quotas to the geometric mean. If the modified quota is smaller than the geometric mean, we're going to use the smaller integer value. So in this case, 9.47 is less than 9.48. We're going to use the smaller integer, which was 9. But if our modified quota is bigger than the geometric mean, we're going to use the bigger integer. So for the next one, 7.485 is bigger than 7.483, so we're going to use the larger integer, which was 8. So now we're comparing 6.486 to 6.480. So the modified quota is bigger. We're going to use the 7. And then the last one, we have 76.494 compared to 76.498. So the geometric mean is bigger. We're going to use the smaller value, which is the 76. And now when we sum those up, they sum to 100 and we've got everything taken care of, so we are good. So again, if the modified quota is smaller, we use the smaller integer value, like in state A and in state D. But if the modified quota is bigger, then we're going to use the larger integer, like in states B and C. It's a little bit funny. Sometimes you have to wonder what these guys, Hill and Huntington, were doing or ingesting when they came up with their methods. But this is the method that they came up with, and mathematically there's some validity to it. So you may be asking yourself, you know, wow, I've got four methods, which one's best? Well, the answer is none of them. They all have issues. And if you read through the last couple slides of your PowerPoint, it talks about some of those issues. And the one that wins is basically determined by who's in power that sets the rules and maybe if they have any ulterior motives that they're trying to kind of push. So, you know, it's interesting. It's stuff to pay attention to, and, you know, next voting cycle, maybe write your representative and let them know what you think. You know, as Americans, we need to voice our opinions if we want our opinions represented with our representatives. So that is the end of our video series for 12C. Please let me know if you have any questions.